Welcome back, 6:53. Time to get you ready to take on your Tuesday here in the morning sprint. Caroline Flynn live at a ballot drop box with how to make sure your vote is counted. Kelsey Morgan takes a closer look at what's at stake in tonight's election. And Mark Peterson is tracking potentially dangerous temperatures in the forecast today. But first, Spokane woke up this morning to the worst air quality in the country. Smoke from a wildfire burning on the Colville Reservation blew back over the Spokane region last night, causing air quality levels to dip into the unhealthy range. It has since improved just slightly, now sitting in the unhealthy for some groups category. According to the Environmental Protection Agency's air monitoring site, as of 5 a.m., Spokane's air quality index was worse than any other location in the U.S. Spokane's index was 152. Next worst location was in El Centro, California, which was at a 116. Since then, an area in North Michigan has taken over now as worst in the country.
And, well, now we do have here a heat advisory that goes into effect at 12 noon. That takes us all the way in tomorrow night. The smoky haze, so seek AC, drink plenty of water, and use caution when you're out and about. Even the healthiest lungs can have issues with this kind of smoke and those winds, so please be careful. We're going to have more on your 7-day forecast and the cool down that's coming.
All right, make sure you get your ballot in today. The deadline to have your vote counted is 8 o'clock tonight if you plan on putting one in a ballot drop box. If you're putting it in the mail, be sure to drop it off as soon as you can because it needs to be postmarked today. At the Spokane County Elections Office, thousands of ballots are already being counted.
And if you do want to put it in one of those ballot drop boxes, hey, by the way, traffic is picking up at this one right here near the Spokane County Elections Office on Gardner. They've got 26 locations throughout the county. A lot of them are focused primarily at libraries, but we've got a full list up for you at KXOY.com right on our homepage so you can find one that's convenient for you maybe as you're heading out to work or leaving the house for the day.
Tonight, the two candidates who get the most votes in each race will move on to the general election, which will be in 3 months on November 5th. The race with the most eyes on it in the city of Spokane is the one for mayor. For Jonathan Bingle, Nadine Woodward, Sean Poole, Kelly Cruz, and Ben Stuckert, it's been a long few months of campaigning. But tonight, that road will end for three of them, and we will finally know which two will face off in November. Other things to keep an eye on tonight include the race for city council president. Philip Tyler, Breanne Beggs, Mike Fagan, and Cindy Wendell will square off in that race. Three city council positions are also up for election. Those three races are all fairly crowded right now, but will be narrowed down to two candidates by tonight. If you see a name on your ballot that you don't know, we have a full voter's guide for you on KXOY.com, where you can learn about each candidate in each race and what they stand for.
Breaking news in just the last few minutes. Novelist Toni Morrison has died. And we'll have more on that for you coming up a little bit later today. Coming up next on Good Morning America, the popular vacation trend going off the grid. Hotels and resorts are now marketing the fact that they have no cell service and no Wi-Fi. All right, you're looking at video from National Night Out. And now, if we can we get to the popular, all right, we're going to Valley Stabbing. And a Spokane Valley man called 911 last night and told dispatchers he had just stabbed his roommate. The Spokane Valley Police Department says deputies took the man into custody at the home in the 12,500 block of East Skyview. Spokane Valley firefighters treated the victim, who was taken to the hospital with possible life-threatening injuries. Major Crimes is now investigating. Valley Police say information on arrest will be released today. And now breaking news in just the last few minutes. Novelist Toni Morrison has died from illness. She was 88 years old. Morrison won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1993. She authored 11 novels over the course of her career, including one titled Beloved, which was made into a film starring Oprah Winfrey in 1998. Now coming up next on Good Morning America, popular vacation trend going off the grid. Hotels and resorts are now marketing the fact they have no cell service and no Wi-Fi.
People are now actually paying to have other people impose disconnection upon them, which is a little bit crazy, frankly, if you think about it.
Coming up, a closer look at the digital detox and why it could be a good idea for you. Two United pilots accused of trying to board a flight while drunk. They were stopped before ever making it into the cockpit when someone smelled alcohol.
I can think of no rational reason why any airline pilot should ever show up for duty with any appreciable amount of alcohol in the bloodstream.
Strangely, nearly 3 years ago to the day, two other United pilots were arrested in this same airport getting ready to fly the same flight.
Well, tonight, when you're looking for your local election results, you can find them on KXOY.com. Ballot drop boxes are open until 8 p.m. Initial results should be announced shortly after that. When they are, you can find the latest numbers and keep an eye on the results as they continue to roll in by clicking this blue bar on our homepage. We'll also have a full update for you on Nightside at 11. But if you don't want to have to look for those results, just download our app. We'll send an alert with the outcome of every major race straight to your phone. To download it, go to the App Store and search for News Now.
Well, the Williams flat fire on the Colville Reservation has now burned nearly 13,000 acres. It's what's causing most of the smoky skies here in Spokane. Crews still say it's only about 20% contained. The Stevens County Sheriff's Office says the fire has now crossed a ridge and flames can be seen from State Route 25 north of the Two Rivers Resort.
Hot weather, a heat advisory in effect today, 96. Tomorrow, 98. Use caution.
All right, that's it for us. Good Morning America is starting right now.